Hello everyone, Michael here with the Daily Note 2 YouTube channel. Welcome to another episode and Happy New Year's everybody. 2012 was a spectacular one, the world didn't end, and I fully expect 2013 to be even more spectacular. So I have a short tip for you guys, and it is all about getting rid of those pesky carrier apps. Did an episode yesterday talking about how I didn't bother getting rid of carrier apps, but it turns out there is a quick and simple way to get rid of carrier apps. So first thing you should do is go to your applications, right, and find a carrier app that you want to get rid of. Now most of these carrier apps sit dormant, so they're not really doing anything and they don't take up too much space, except there may be one. So for example, for me, I have this app called U+Box. It is very similar to Dropbox, and I'm sure it's a good app, but I really don't need this app, especially when it looks through all my photos every week and tells me how many photos I have to upload to U+Box. So I really want to get rid of it because it is eating my battery. So the best way to do this is to hit the menu button, hit edit, and you could actually tap and drag, and this app info shows up. Now the disable option there, the disable button is not there because there have been some updates that were installed, but you could simply do uninstall updates, then it'll say it'll be replaced with the factory version. After it replaces the factory version, do the same motion, right? Drag it to app info, and now you can disable it. And when you go back, you will see that app is virtually almost uninstalled. It is nowhere there. And let's do it with one more app. There's this app called V3 Mobile 2.0. This time you see there are no updates, so we could just go right ahead and disable it. And same thing, it disappeared. Now what happens when you accidentally go overboard and do too many of these and you find out you actually need the app? Just go to your home, menu, settings, and then application manager, and then go to all and scroll all the way down, and you'll see I have a list of apps that I've disabled, and you could just simply tap on it and then you could click on the enable button. And here's an option: if you for some reason want to reset this whole process, you could just hit on menu. And then you could do reset app preferences, but it's going to reset everything. For example, it'll re-enable the apps, and then if you've disabled any notifications, it'll re-enable those and the default applications as well. So just letting you know before you reset the whole thing. So anyway, that's my short tip for today, but it should be a good one and it should save you some battery. So if you haven't been to my channel yet, please come to my channel and check out my 100 plus videos on the Samsung Galaxy Note 2. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe because I create an episode a day so that you can get the most out of your Samsung Galaxy Note 2. Once again, thank you for watching.